Hello, my name is Carrie with iScaper 1, and lately our dishwasher has been leaving the dishes cloudy with a film, and there's also small particles of food stuck on them. I went online and downloaded the owner's manual, but it was no help on how to clean the filter in the dishwasher. I also searched for videos or instructions on the dishwasher that covered removing and cleaning the filter, but I couldn't find any. So I downloaded the parts list for the dishwasher and decided I would tackle a project on how to remove and clean the filter. The first thing I need to do is remove the lower dish rack from the tub. Next, I'll remove the upper dish rack by prying out on the tab and removing each cover on the slide rails for the upper rack. When the slide rail covers are removed, I'll pull out to remove the upper rack. Next, I'll go to the lower spray arm. Notice that if I lift up gently on the spray arm and twist counterclockwise, the spray arm will spin out of the hub nut below it. Then I'll grasp the hub nut and twist counterclockwise around a quarter of a turn. When it's loose, it will pull up and out of the venturi. With the hub nut out, I can then remove the fine filter assembly by lifting straight up. Before I remove the venturi, I need to remove the supply tube that feeds the middle and upper spray arm. In the parts description, it's called the conduit main. So I'll take a 1/4-inch nut driver and remove the bolt that secures the supply tube and spray arm to the upper tub on the dishwasher. Then I'll remove the upper spray arm. Next, I'll go to the center of the tub and pry out on the ends of the plastic clip that secures the supply tube in place. Notice how this releases the tube. Finally, I'll go to where the supply tube connects to the venturi and lift up on the tab where the supply tube enters the venturi. When I carefully pull straight back, this will allow me to pull the end of the tube out of the venturi housing. With the supply tube removed, I can now pull the filter cover off the filter. And next I'll twist counterclockwise to thread the venturi out of the pump connector fitting. Removing the filter is where I got stuck on this project. With the filter cover removed, it looks like the filter should pull up and out of the opening. But after squeezing the center of the filter, it still seems to be stuck in place. The lip of the filter is on top of the filter screen, so to me it makes sense that it should come out first. After taking another look at the filter online, I noticed that about halfway down the filter, there are tabs on each side. It looks to me like that's what's locking it in place in the sump housing. So with a small screwdriver, I'll push it gently down on one side of the filter where I think the tab will be. It worked on the front side and released the filter. So I'll hold the outer edge of the filter in place with one hand and do the same thing on the back side of the filter, prying carefully with a screwdriver towards the inside of the filter. When both tabs are released, I can lift straight up to pull the filter out of the sump housing. The filter did lock the coarse filter screen in place, so with the filter out, I can now remove the coarse screen. With the coarse screen and the filter out, I'll take this opportunity to clean the bottom of the tub with some Clorox wipes. And while I'm at it, I'll clean the door seals and the door edges. Next, I'll take all the removed parts to the sink and do some cleaning on the parts. First, I'll start with the coarse screen, and with a brush and some soap, I'll clean both sides of the screen. Then I'll do the same thing with the venturi, the hub nut, and the filter basket. When I was removing the spray arms, I noticed that some of the ports in the spray arms were plugged off with food. This has probably affected how clean the dishes were getting. So I'll take a small toolpick and start on the upper spray arm, and after removing the obstructions from the ports, I'll run water through them from one end of the spray arm to the other to check that there are no other pieces of food plugging them off. Next, I'll remove the middle spray arm from the upper rack with a 1/4-inch nut driver and check it for plugged ports. This spray arm had a piece of plastic stuck in one of the ports, and once I get it out, I'll run water from one end of the ports to the other and see if anything more plugs a port off. When I get done, I'll reattach the spray arm to the upper basket with the bolt and a 1/4-inch nut driver. Be sure here that the cleaning ports point up to the bottom of the upper rack. Finally, I'll take the lower spray arm and check the ports on it for any obstructions. When the obstructions are removed and after I flush out the spray arm, I'm now ready to begin reassembling the clean parts back into the tub of the dishwasher. The next step is to take the coarse filter screen and position it in place. Then I'll take the filter basket with the holes in the basket pointing forward and snap it into place. Then I'll replace the filter cover. After the filter cover is on, I'll take the Venturi and thread it clockwise back into the pump connector. Next, I'll take the supply tube to the upper rack and push the end into the opening on the Venturi. Then I'll twist the Venturi a little more to line it up better with the clip for the supply tube in the center of the tub. And when it's lined up, I'll snap the supply tube into the clip. Lastly, I'll take the supply tube end, align it with a fitting in the top of the tub, and insert the bolt through the spray arm and tighten the bolt with a 1/4-inch nut driver. Make sure here that the ports in the spray arm point down. With the supply tube reinstalled, I'll take the fine filter assembly and insert the one end into the tube coming out of the coarse filter screen. Then I'll center the assembly over the top of the Venturi. Next, I'll take the tub nut and slide it over the top of the Venturi. When I get everything aligned, I'll twist clockwise around a 1/4 turn until the nut locks into place. Finally, I'll take the lower spray arm and center it over the hub nut. If I rotate the spray arm as I position it, it will eventually align correctly and drop down into place. The spray arm should spin freely, and if I pull up gently, notice that it has locked back into place. The final two items are the bottom rack and the upper rack. The bottom rack slides right in, and on the upper rack, I'll insert the wheels on the rack into the slide rails, and when the rack is slid in, I'll reattach the cover caps. Okay, all the parts are clean and back in place. What I'll do next is take the cloudy, food-spotted wine glasses and place them in the upper rack. Then I'll take a glass measuring cup and fill up with a couple cups of distilled white vinegar. What I'm going to do is run a cycle with the white vinegar, which will hopefully remove any of the hard deposits that are left in the dishwasher that I missed, and will clean the wine glasses in the process. When the wash cycle is done, I'll remove the glasses and see what the results are. The glass measuring cup that had the vinegar has some small deposits in the bottom of the glass, and the wine glasses look a lot better, but still show some of the small food deposits. So what I'll try next is to load the dishwasher with dishes again, put the wine glasses back in, and run a cycle using dishwasher detergent. When the cycle finishes, I'll check the dishes again. If there's any white film on the dishes, it should show up on the black kitchen utensils. They look good, so I'll move to the upper rack and look at the wine glass. It looks good too. There's no white film or small food deposits. So it appears that the filter cleaning worked, and it looks like the dishwasher is cleaning like it should again. When the problem comes back, I now know the steps to take to clean the filter. If you like this video, please share it and click the thumbs up. And if you'd like to see more of my videos, please visit my YouTube channel, iScaper1.